Getting a puppy is a huge responsibility, and not many would know what they're going to experience while it grows. When they're small, they have to be house-trained, leash-trained, and know basic tricks like sit, wait, or no. Teaching a pup how to behave is very important if you want a healthy and happy dog without weird incidents. And when a woman purchased an adorable Japanese Spitz, she was ready to teach him everything and give him all that he needed. She was a devoted dog owner. However, it turned out that she wasn't actually a dog owner. Before we begin, make sure to click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification button for more amazing videos. When Ms. Wang, who lives in China, saw an adorable white pup, she immediately fell in love. She bought him and took him to his new home. But while the pup started to grow, things started to look weird. All was well until her pup reached the age of 3 months. Then her tiny ball of fluff started to change into something that didn't really look like a Japanese Spitz. You won't believe what she says next. The fur got thicker when it reached 3 months old. Its face became pointy, and its tail grew longer than that of a normal dog, says Ms. Wang. Then she noticed one more thing that made her look for an expert's advice. "Other pet dogs seem to be scared of my pet, so I walked it on a leash," explained the owner. "It's tough to train a pup on your own, especially when it's only a baby." But this baby dog wasn't really a dog. On the internet, many guides explain how different breeds of dogs behave or look. The Japanese Spitz is very intelligent, loyal, and a loving companion. Wang's pup was exactly like that, but he wasn't a Spitz. Many breeds of dogs vary in size. The Spitz has a thick and fluffy coat and slanted eyes. They love to run a lot, but will also enjoy curling up in their owner's laps. All the information on this Spitz didn't explain this pup's behavior. Miss Wang finally took her dog to see an expert on animals. She went to a local zoo, and a staff member couldn't believe his eyes. This woman was actually walking what was supposed to be a wild animal. When the staff member at the zoo saw her, he said, "Based on the size, it is a domesticated fox. It carries a smell in their body, and that smell can get stronger as it grows older." How did this woman end up with a fox? How can you not know when you buy a dog that it's not actually a dog? Well, in this case, the white fox pup really looks like a Spitz puppy, but when it grows, its tail gets longer and it starts to smell weird. And that's not all. Many pet shops sell foxes in Asia. Some shops sell them as foxes, while others tell customers they're dogs. So, unsuspecting pet owners like Ms. Wang end up raising foxes instead of fluffy dogs. Looking at this young fox, it's obvious Ms. Wang tried her best to take care of him. She loved him a lot and wanted to make sure he doesn't miss anything, but he wasn't so happy with the food he was getting. You see, before Ms. Wang didn't know her fox was a dog, the pup was less inclined to eat his chicken and dog food. After finding out he was a fox, she knew he wouldn't lead a good life in the house. He needed freedom and friends. A true animal lover like Ms. Wang knew a fox wasn't going to be pleased with living inside a house. The best home for a domesticated fox would be in a zoo, with others like him. Fortunately, she knew the perfect place. Ms. Wang went back to the zoo where she found out she owned a fox instead of a dog. The zoo agreed to take the fox in, put him in quarantine for a while to make sure he is healthy. He was going to live a great life. Finally, the young fox found a home where he lived with others like him. He was going to make a lot of friends, and he also had a proper diet and veterinary care. Ms. Wang was very sad, but she had to let him go. Keeping a fox indoors is a bad idea. They need a lot of space to roam, so Ms. Wang would have come home one day to see her house destroyed after her pet fox grew into an adult. Moreover, they can be very smelly. However sad that Ms. Wang was to part with her fox pup, she knew she made the right choice. And the great news is that the zoo allowed Ms. Wang to visit her fox whenever she misses him. This fox has a better life in the zoo, free to run in the outdoors and to socialize with other foxes. He gets a proper diet and he is also safe. Moreover, Ms. Wang can always go back and see him as he grows older. If Miss Wang wants to have another try at getting a pup, she should take a better look at the next dog and make sure it's not a different kind of pup. We think she'll look for a different type of breed next time, just to be sure. If you're thinking of getting a Japanese Spitz and you live in Asia, consider taking a dog expert with you to avoid any problems. Or take a better look and know the difference between a fox pup and a little pooch.